Shut up and sit down.
Hey, I'm Simon.
I'm Ellie.
Hey. Hello. How are you?
Good. You alright?
Hey, I'm Simon.
I'm Ellie.
And if you enjoy our videos, please remember to like, comment, subscribe, and of course, hit that zombie bell thing. And as usual tonight, as with every other night of the week, because we do this every day, we are surprising each other with trailers that the other person has not yet seen and filming our typically stupid reactions.
So what do we have next?
So this is something we reacted to the teaser for, and I was thinking, this movie comes out on May 14th. I mean, really, really soon. So I probably don't need to see another trailer for it. I'm probably as excited as I'm going to get. However, there's a new trailer for Army of the Dead, and everybody's talking about it.
Everybody.
What are you guys doing? Don't you have a hobby? Maybe watching us. Yeah, exactly. Well, so we are going to check out the new trailer for Army of the Dead. Neither of us has seen it yet. If you want to see what we think about it, hang around until the end. But for now,
let's go.
Brains.
As Vegas was walled off, the zombies left inside the haunting abandoned city.
Mr. Ward, how would you like to make $50 million? On a warm summer's evening, on a train bound for nowhere, met up with a gambler. We were both too tired to sleep, so we took turns of staring out the window at the darkness. The boredom overtook us, and he began to speak. He said, "Son, I've made a life out of reading people's faces.
Think about it. Everything we did, all those people we saved.
The way they held their eyes.
Look what it got us.
You don't mind my saying.
Now what if?
I can see you're out of age.
What if just once?
For a taste of your whiskey,
we did something just for us.
You ready to play?
Yeah.
There's $200 million in the vault beneath the strip. With a 32-hour window to get it out. Find the safe. This should be a simple in and out.
It's not too late to go back.
If you're gonna play the game, you gotta play. Oh my god.
Oh no. That's a lot.
What the ass? Nice.
They're not what you think they are. They're smarter. They're faster. They're organized.
Wow. They really are. Oh my god.
Oh, scheiße.
Yeah. You got to know when to fold them. Know when to run. Elvis. Know when to run.
Sitting at the table, there'll be time enough to count. When the deal's done.
What is this?
Oh no!
Oh, wow. Zombie tiger. That's crossing the line.
Whoa. Wow. So you got to know when to fold, you got to know when to hold them, and you got to know when there's an army of the dead outside your casino, I guess.
Yes, good to know that if it happens.
Yeah, so that told us a lot more about Zack Snyder's The Army of the Dead. What did you think of it?
It looks amazing and also terrifying. And I do agree that a zombie tiger is crossing the line.
Yeah.
Because we've seen fast zombies before, and we've seen big kind of impenetrable walls of zombies, and obviously we've seen teams kind of gearing up to face those things. What we haven't seen is organized zombies.
Yeah, that was a really interesting spin. It kind of reminded me of like the Uruk-hai in Lord of the Rings, that kind of a feel to them, that there was a definite leader. They were definitely ganging around. There was some sexiness going on between zombies at one point as well. That sexy burlesque dancer
that
zombie.
That definitely crosses a line.
Yeah. Although there's been multiple kind of zombie properties like comics and things where really sick and twisted individuals have had their sexy time with zombies. So, yeah, I think that line was crossed quite a while ago. But we've not seen, as far as I've noticed, two zombies having sexy times together. So, yeah, maybe some grossness between zombies in this one. And in our teaser reaction, I talked about how I've only ever been to Vegas for business, never for fun. I'm sure Vegas is a really fun town if you go in for a weekend with friends or a loved one, or maybe even just on your own for a weekend of drunken debauchery or whatever you do there. Working there for 5 days, not so much fun when you're just walking up and down that strip in the beating sun when everybody else is having fun. And there have often been times when I've wished for a horde of zombies to come running into a casino just to end my pain. However, this doesn't look as much fun as I was imagining that horde of zombies to look. Those zombies were seriously fast. Mm. The heroes seem to be running out of bullets, which is a common theme in zombie movies. I also really liked what we saw about the team this time as well. Any particular people that jumped out at you in the team of heroes?
Tig Notaro, obviously.
Tig Notaro, yes, indeed.
She's awesome.
And we know her from
Star Trek.
From Star Trek Discovery, of course.
And her stand-up is really good.
Oh, I've not seen her stand-up, but she was awesome in Star Trek Discovery. She was probably my favorite character on that show. A really interesting choice to put in a zombie action movie as well, but she looks like she fits right in with...
She does, which is hilarious, because she shouldn't.
Yeah.
And she'd be the first to say it. Right. She's not an action type at all.
You know, the only thing that confused me, though, I'm sure, and maybe I misheard this, I need to go back and watch the trailer, I'm sure there were $200 million in a vault under the casino, and that's what our friend Drax and his crew were hired to go in and steal, but they promised him $50 million, and there's about a dozen other people in his team. So does he have to split his $50 million with the other people? Or do those other people get like $1 million each or $2 million? Like, is there a sliding scale? Maybe Dave Bautista's so big that he warrants a greater share of the loot.
Oh, you think it's divided by weight?
Maybe it is. I mean, but it made me think, I mean, you've got the criminal mastermind behind all this who sent that team in, and did he really send them in for that $200 million, or do they open the vault and there's nothing there, apart from maybe it opens into that place with a million zombies in?
Mm.
I don't know. Well, I don't know what his evil gains are. And also, in the zombie apocalypse, what are you going to do with $200 million?
Maybe it's localized zombie apocalypse.
Maybe. Yeah, it could be.
Another bits are good.
You know, I've always wondered, as the zombie apocalypse progresses, and I guess we saw some of this in Fear the Walking Dead, that things are kind of normal for a while, but I always wondered with the COVID-19 pandemic if it was kind of like that, where the kids are still forced to go into school and you're still trying to tell them to do their homework while there are zombies clawing on the window outside.
Yeah.
I know, but your math still needs to be done.
Yeah.
And you posted a joke the other day about how if the government said there were slightly fewer zombies, would everyone just rush back out to restaurants again and think it was fine to go out? But yeah, it's been a weird time of introspection about the zombie apocalypse, I guess, over the last year. But yeah, maybe this is a localized zombie apocalypse, but there were a butt ton of them.
That was a lot of zombies. And if they're clever, sentient zombies as well, that's not good.
Yeah.
You have to wonder what their end game is, because zombies normally just want to eat people.
Mostly brains.
So why would they be... Like, if they're being clever about it, are they just being more clever with trying to eat more people? It doesn't seem to warrant the kind of brain power they're putting into it somehow.
Yeah, I really don't know. I gotta say, though, I was a little bit shocked that a zombie apocalypse movie where everything seems hopeless and the world looks like it's ending still felt more cheerful than Zack Snyder's Justice League. But hey, maybe that's just me. Maybe it's personal preference. Either way, well, you won't need to wait very long to see this because it's coming in May, folks.
May.
In May! Not long away at all. But of course, you won't have to wait very long to see us again, because you know how often we do this?
I don't know. No idea.
Every apocalypse. Every day of the apocalypse.
Oh, that makes sense.
Yeah. Every day of the COVID-19 pandemic apocalypse, we do YouTube videos. And maybe when it's all gone in Never Embrary, we'll stop doing this. But for until then, it's every single day.
Every day.
So we will see you then, friends, on the next Dork trailer ambush.
Peace out, zombies.
Brains.
Shut up and sit down.